buat the nationalists. Jokowi want a granular amnesty.
Presiden Joko Widodo said we cannot enforce the ruling concerning by Nuzrul Mahmud, a West Nusa Tenggara teacher who was confident of defending the resocialization. Activists have urged Jokowi to grant real amnesty. We have to respect the legal process and respect the Supreme Concession. As the head of the government, I cannot enforce that ruling, he told reporter on Monday. He encouraged Nuzrul to submit a case review to the Supreme Court in the order to seek justice. If the case review does not provide justice, they can apply for claims to the president. He said, once he has applied for claims, that's where I come in. The same court sentenced Nuzrul to 6 months imprisonment and ordered her to pay $5 million after finding her guilty of demanding the principal of the public high school where she worked. The 37-year-old mother of the girl was accused of circulating a recording of a phone call in which the principal related the sordid detail of an affair they had with another. She claims that only despite the phone call and that the recording was destroyed by another person. A group of activists called the qualification to save Ibu Nuzrul has called on Jokowi to grant Nuzrul amnesty. We swap clip to help change. Representative from the qualification, we meet office the work president staff on the menu to present the written request and a copy of petition signed by one of the 100,000 people in support of amnesty. The staff reads the letter and petition and promised to show it to the president, said qualification member and Institute for Clinical Justice Reform, or IGCR Executive Director Anggara. Amnesty is one of their power granted to the president to interest the legal matters by the constitution, the two others being claimants and abolition. Abolition will not be applied to the Nuzrul's case as will have to be granted before his case went to trial. By giving amnesty, the person is questioned is considered not guilty. The claimants on the other hand is given to people who have been proven guilty and admit their guilt. Constitutional let as per Ferryam said, the convicted person has to apply for clemency, but amnesty can be granted on the invitation of the president. He believed that in Nuzrul's case, amnesty was the correct step to take, the adding that it will not amount to interference in the legal process.
So that's it for first news from us. Now we will move on to the next news coming from the natural world, which is about Blackpink Jennie's settling on solo for you.
Jennie Lately's solo track, Solo, has dominated the local digital music charts ever since it released November 12. The song was only top South Korea music streaming site, but ranked number one on iTunes charts in 43 countries. Jennie also became the first female K-pop solo artist to make it to the top spot on the iTunes worldwide song chart. YouTube views of the music video surpassed 10 million within 15 hours of its release. The figure topped 50 million in 4 days and 14 hours, a record for a solo female K-pop singer. YG Entertainment released 2 dance videos for the song, one on Friday and one on Saturday. Both of these were well received by fans. Starting Saturday, Jennie will perform solo live on major TV stations. The TV appearances were previously scheduled for November 16 until 17, and the dance videos were released in effort to make up for the delay. This is the news I will present to you, so thank you for attention and have a wonderful day. See you next time and bye bye.